What's going on, guys? So normally I don't upload on a Tuesday, but I'm actually doing like a little challenge with myself to see if I can upload 7 times in 7 days, so daily vlogging basically, or daily uploads. And I'm doing this because I've been researching how to get like more engagement, more views, more subscribers to my channel, or more traffic to my channel. And one of the things that kept coming up is that YouTube actually pushes people that upload daily up to like the first page on YouTube and stuff like that. Like, they sort of boost the people that upload more frequently, because if you upload more frequently, then obviously people will watch you more, people stay on YouTube longer, and that will help YouTube in the long run as well. So I thought, you know what, let's actually put it to the test. Let's see what would happen to my channel if I upload 7 times in 7 days, just for 1 week. Like, I probably won't be able to keep up daily uploads. My life isn't interesting enough to do daily uploads anyway. But I thought, you know, just as a little challenge to see if I can do it, if I can put up with it. 7 uploads, 7 days. So anyway, I got a question a while back about what books I read or recommend if you want to start your own business, or just business books in general. And I never really answered it. Like, it was like a while back, and I thought, you know what, this is the perfect opportunity to go a little bit more in depth into that. I done a fitness upload yesterday, so, you know, I thought, you know what, I'll do like a business type content creation type of upload today. So anyway, the first book I recommend if you want to start your own business is The 4-Hour Workweek. Like, for those of you that are in my inner circle will know how much I've been raving about this book. Basically, The 4-Hour Workweek is about it's not really about like working 4 hours a week per se. It's about putting like certain processes in place so that you only have to like manage your business for 4 hours a week. And one of the takeaway points that I got from this book, or like one of the key points in this book, is about wealth and being rich. Like, what is being rich? That's what they explain in the book. Like, you've got fella A who earns 50,000 euros a year, and then you got fella B who's earning 100,000 euros a year. Who's richer? Obviously, everyone's gonna say B. And then he goes on to say, well, what if person A only works 10 hours a week as opposed to person B working 40 hours a week? Who's richer? Like, obviously, some people will still say, well, it's still person B, you know, he's earning more money at the end of the day. And then he goes on to say, well, what if person A only spends 1,000 euros a month? Like, he can like live and be happy on 1,000 euros a month, as opposed to person B having to spend like 4,000 or 5,000 euros a month to keep up with his you know, his activities and stuff like that. And basically it explains that wealth and being rich, like, money is not it's a means to an end. It's not an end in itself. Money won't get you happiness. Basically, what you need to realize is that if you want to do something, just go out and do it. You don't actually need the money. Well, obviously you will need money, but you don't need as much money as you think. Like, people are always like procrastinating and waiting for that moment to be happy. Like, you'll think like, oh, when I retire, I'll be happy because I'll have money and I'll be able to do what I want. But you can actually do what you want now, and that's like, it was like a bit of a mind fuck. Like, it made me realize that. Like, for example, I want to travel a lot more, and I'm constantly thinking like, I need money to travel the world, you know, stuff like that. And he explains in the book, Tim Ferriss, he says like, you don't actually need as much money as you think. Like, if you go and travel the world now, you'll realise that you won't need millions and millions of euros or dollars or pounds to travel the world. Anyway, that was book number one. Book number two that I highly recommend is The Personal MBA. And this book has actually, it was such an eye-opener for me. Like, it actually made me realise that I don't want to do a master's in business. Like, I've actually decided after that book that I'm not going to go for a master's in business, because like, that book explained it so in depth, like all the stuff that you need to know about business and about running your own business, and like all the different process of business, value creation, stuff like that. It just explains all of it. It's like 4 years of uni compressed into 400 pages of one book, you know. And all that for, what was it, 20 euros or something, as opposed to what is the Dutch education, like, how much is it now? I think it's like 10,000 euro if you have 4 years of uni, you know. Like, the difference is so immense. And the book just goes into like everything from value creation to selling, to bringing like traffic to your business and creating customers for your business and marketing and selling. You know, it's just everything in one. I highly recommend you read it if you're trying to get into business, or you're doing a business course, or anything to do with business. Read that book. I just realized I've actually got it again. Personal MBA by Josh Kaufman. Highly recommend. Right, so book number three is another book that I've actually got here, and it's from Patrick McGuinness, and it's called The 10% Entrepreneur. And what this book made me realize is that, like, I've always wanted to start my own business, and that's because like, my granddad came here. Like, he moved to Holland and he started his own recruitment agency, and to this day that is still a successful recruitment agency even though he's passed away. And that's always stuck in my mind, that I want to also like start my own business and be like my own boss and stuff like that. But it's hard to like to get from thinking it to actually doing it, because there's so many risks, there's so much like endless hours of work, and it might not work out and stuff like that. And it's really hard to go from like a stable income of like a full-time or a part-time job to actually going out into the real world and starting your own business. And this book's made me realize that you don't actually need to like step away from your day job if you want to start your own business. Like, you can actually keep the day job and like go out and just like do it part-time, like in your own time, start your own business and just keep working at it like, at a slightly slower pace, because obviously you've got more time, you haven't got as much time as you normally would, because you've also got your other job. And then until you've actually reached that point where you're earning just as much, if not more, with your little venture as your regular day job, and then you can quit your day job, and then you can, you know, then you've got your own business. Another thing Patrick McGuinness explains in this book is called the 10% entrepreneur, obviously the title of this book as well. And he explains that you can also do both, that you can actually have your day job as your full-time income, and then you can have like another revenue stream or income stream with your little side hustle. And I think that also intertwines nicely with the 4-hour work week, the book I've been explaining about before, because in that book they also explain about virtual assistants and automating certain business processes so that you only have to work 4 hours. And I think that intertwines nicely with this book, because that is also about like automating certain processes so you can do both, like work a day job and have a little side hustle. Another book I highly recommend is Dotcom Secrets. I haven't even finished it yet, but there's already so much value that I've got out of this book. And basically it's like, the whole point of this book is to turn something you're passionate about or something that you're knowledgeable about into income or like a revenue stream, and turn that into your own online business. And it also goes a little more in depth and explains that how you can get people from a larger audience and funnel them into like a sales funnel, and then eventually turn them people into customers as well, by giving them a loads amounts of value up front, and then slowly getting them to sort of almost feel like they feel obliged to buy something off you, because you've gotten so much value up front, so much value for their money, that they'll in the end they will buy your product or service. Like I said, I haven't even finished this book, can't wait to finish it. Once I actually do finish it, I will give a little more in-depth review on it, but so much value in this book already, it's unbelievable. I'm only on page 115. And last but not least, the smallest book of the five, Manage on Oneself by Peter Drucker. And in this book he explains that there's certain things that you're good at, like your strengths, and you need to go all in on those strengths instead of like neglecting them and trying to improve stuff that you're not really good at. It just says it's a waste of time, and you just need to go all in on your strengths. Go all in on that one skill that you're good at and keep perfecting that one skill. So this book is about like finding out what your true strengths are, perfecting them, like going all in on them, and then like that will bring you to the top, or that will get you to the top. So anyway guys, those are my top 5 books. Like, they are the books that I've read and I've got the most value out of when starting my own business and like doing business in general. Like this video if you got something out of it, comment down below if you got any books that you recommend, subscribe to the channel for more, and I'll see you guys tomorrow.
Gotta do what I gotta do.